What's up guys, my name is Kelsey and welcome to my video series, Stock Market for Beginners, Part 1. The very first step to investing in the stock market is to open an account with a broker. Today, I'll be talking about two really popular brokerage firms. Quick note, I'm not a financial advisor. This video is just for entertainment purposes only. All right, you ready? Let's first start off with, what is a brokerage firm? A brokerage firm is basically a company that will buy and sell stocks for you. In the past, you would actually have to interact with a person, a stockbroker, who would buy and sell the stocks for you. But now, everything is online, so you don't have to interact with people anymore. Which is great for introverts like me. I'm honestly a very awkward person to talk to, but okay, carry on. Two really popular brokerage firms to use are Robinhood and Webull. Both are completely free to open an account with, and they don't charge a commission. What I mean by commission is, for example, TD Ameritrade, they used to charge a $6.95 commission for every stock you bought or sold. So honestly, if you trade a lot in the long run, you would be losing a lot of money if you were to go with a broker that charged a commission. So Robinhood and Webull, they are both very competitive with each other. It's always interesting to see what kind of promotions they offer to entice more like new investors. So for Robinhood, when you sign up with them, you get one free stock. And for Webull, you get one free stock for signing up with them and another free stock for depositing $100 into your account. Let's talk about the difference between these two brokers. Robinhood is very easy to use, and a lot of people who are first starting out in the stock market, they use Robinhood. For me, I have a Robinhood and a Webull account. When I first started investing, I started with Robinhood. But let's just take a look at how clean Robinhood's interface is. Okay, so we are currently looking at Robinhood. It is 12:18 right now. So the stock market is still open. Quick note for people who live in California, the stock market opens at 6:30 a.m. and it closes at 1 p.m. So it's gonna close in like 40 minutes. Right now it's like 12:18 p.m. Right now we're looking at Tesla. So as you can see right here, this is the price chart. Today, Tesla opened at $1,435.20. And right now it's currently trading at $1,527. So from this price chart, you can see that Tesla increased about $108 today. So that's a 7.67% increase, which is, wow, it's pretty amazing. But yeah, this is Robinhood. It's pretty clean to look at, really nice. Right now it's currently 5:28 p.m. Pacific time. The stock market officially closed at 1 p.m. today, but it actually really closed at 5 p.m. because there's still after hours trading. After hours trading goes from 1 p.m. to 5 p.m. Pacific time. For Robinhood, they allow you to trade after hours until 3 p.m. Webull, on the other hand, lets you trade after hours until 5 p.m. Pacific time. So let's see, today Tesla closed after hours at $1,543.50 per stock. Wow, I love Tesla. Ow, my elbow. Robinhood also has an added feature so you can look at more technical stuff. If you take a look here, click this, and then voila. First thing we look at is a candlestick chart, so we're no longer looking at line charts. Candlestick charts can give you a better idea of where a stock's price is headed next by looking at patterns. But that's like a whole different video, so moving on. Robinhood also added trade indicators to help you decide like when to buy and sell a stock. But okay, now let's move on to Webull. Webull also offers candlestick charts, and they have like 20 different indicators. To be honest, I've only used like 4 of them. I think what really sets the two brokers apart is the information that Webull offers. If we take a quick look at the financial tab, you'll see that Webull offers so much more information. Look at that. Financial forecasts, financial statements. They also give the balance sheet. My goodness, amazing, amazing. Webull. I personally am using both brokers. As I stated earlier in the video, I started off with Robinhood as a total beginner, didn't know anything about stocks. Fun fact, I actually started trading back late April. April 2020. After I learned more how to trade, I moved on to Webull. I would recommend that if you're completely new to trading stocks, that you just start off with Robinhood. It's so much more easier to navigate around as compared to Webull. But you could also open a Robinhood and a Webull account at the same time. There's nothing wrong with that. If you start off with Robinhood and decide you want to switch to Webull later, have no fear. Webull made this very easy for you because they are very competitive. So if you decide to switch brokers from Robinhood to Webull, Robinhood will charge you $75 for doing that. But here's where competitive Webull comes into play. Webull has this promotion in which they will cover a transfer fee up to $100. The only reason why I haven't switched completely from Robinhood to Webull is that when you decide to move your stocks from another broker to Webull, you have to at least wait 5 to 7 days. And during that time period, you can't trade at all. And right now I'm like actively trading, so like I'm kind of impatient and I can't wait that long, man. There's too many things going on in the stock market. Also, another reason why I haven't moved all my stocks from Robinhood to Webull is because I'm waiting for the next promotion. Webull does like these random, like really good promotions if you transfer from a broker to their broker, because like you have to keep in mind they're very competitive. Like the last promotion they did, if you like move stocks, they were willing to give you 25 free stocks if you deposit at least $25,000. So I was like, maybe I'll just wait for the next promotion, like, I don't know, next year or something. Like, there's no rush for me, so I don't see why not. I'm hoping next year they, like, I don't know, ramp up their promotions. There has been some cases where Robinhood has shut down and people who are doing option trading, that was a bad day for them because they couldn't get out of a trade and they potentially lost a lot of money. For me, I don't trade options on Robinhood. I just buy and sell stocks on there. Also, another thing I've noticed, this is just me being like real OCD, but Webull tends to load a stock's price fluctuation faster than Robinhood. Ow! Faster than Robinhood. But yeah, as you can see here, probably like half a second. I don't know how to measure this. All right, that's it for this video. I've included the links for both brokers in my description. If you guys sign up with my link, I get a free stock, you get a free stock. It's a win-win situation. If you don't sign up with my link, that's fine. You guys can still get a free stock by yourself. If you guys can, please like and subscribe. It really helps this channel out. And look forward to part 2. We're gonna talk about investing. All right, peace.